It's well known that the technological sector is dominated by men. And I was curious how this gender bias translates to apps and innovations on a consumer level. Let's take a look at how women's health is being taken care of by the tech industry. In spite of the slogan of diversity pinned on the flag of many tech companies, the field is dominated by men. With the Big Bang Theory, Silicon Valley, and the social network, it's easy to imagine Silicon Valley as a bunch of guys in hoodies and flip-flops solving big problems with women as sidekicks rather than protagonists. Women hold only 11% of executive positions at Silicon Valley companies and only own 5% of startups. And it shows. The majority of the period tracker apps fail women miserably. Fitness trackers and wearables are useless when it comes to pregnancy. Most of our apps were designed and developed without the input of their future consumers. And it's not like there is no demand. In the health category, period tracking apps are reportedly the fourth most popular. Yet, it took years for Fitbit and Apple Watch to add it as a feature. And on the app side, a recent study showed that 95% of menstrual cycle tracking apps are inaccurate for patient use, and almost none of them cite medical literature or health professional involvement. But women's health is not only about period tracking and pregnancy. A lot less consideration is given to other female health problems as well, such as menopause, cancer detection, breastfeeding troubles, troubles around bladder control, and a lot more. While digital health companies already appear in these areas, their number is quite low, and they are usually struggling to get funded. Let's take a look at Next Gen Jane, a San Francisco-based startup that promises to get insights into female reproductive health from menstrual blood in order to detect early biomarkers for endometriosis, cervical cancer, or other conditions. They struggled to get funding for years. So, if there is demand, and these issues affect half of the population, why do only 10% of investor money go to women-led startups? Why do tech companies overlook features specific to women? It's terrible to see how digital health is failing those in need. So, here's a wake-up call. Femtech investors, women's health advocates, as well as fitness wearable manufacturers, step forward and create solutions that serve the entire population.